CultureBuzz Shalom. My name is Meira Muchawsky Parnas. I was born in Jerusalem. I live in Jerusalem. Welcome to my exhibition at the new wing of the Tel Aviv Museum of Art. This exhibition is part of the Andy Prize exhibition 2013, created by Meira Yagid, Haimovici. In this exhibition, I'm exhibiting six installation works. They're made out of ceramic materials and plaster, and they were all done throughout the last year. I think in my works, I try to convey various expressions of time and of temporariness, presence and absence. And and my sources of inspiration are all from my domestic surrounding. Could be objects that have accompanied me for some time. Could be the view, the landscape of that I see from my balcony in Jerusalem. I suggest we stroll around, and I will tell you the story behind the scenes of a few of my books. It's a translation of the known plastic colorful hula hoop into a ceramic slip cast. As you can hear, it's hollow and fragile. And this work was actually triggered by a memory of a children's birthday ritual that is very common here in Israel, in nurseries. In this ritual, the birthday child has to jump from one hoop to another. The number of hoops is the age of the child. Say the child is 4 years, has to jump four hoops. And I think it symbolizes the shift between 1 year to another. I recently turned 40. And I think in general, age or the passage of time is something that is very difficult to grasp. I think time is an abstract concept. And by translating it into a measurable amount into something, an object with a physical presence in space, it makes it, I think, easier to comprehend what time means. And if you look at it, you see that 40 is quite a lot. Tell you another story about this work. This work is called Pola and Leza. And Pola and Leza were my late paternal grandparents. And they have made this knotted woolen carpet for me as a gift from their lovely granddaughter as a child. And I grew up with this carpet in my bedroom from early childhood through adolescence, and it moved on with me to my own home, and in a certain point it was time time to let go. I mean, the carpet became shabby, strings started to tear, and no one wanted it. My sons did not want it. They have expressed their dislike to the carpet. Anyway, I found it extremely difficult to throw this carpet away. Emotionally, I couldn't, and I decided to make a kind of a death mask to the carpet. I've cast the carpet in a plaster. So what you see here is actually the imprint of the carpet. So the carpet itself is gone. I know that from first sight it seems as if the carpet is still in, but it ain't here. What happened was that the pigments of the wool have been absorbed into the plaster, and the fibers were also stuck inside, and it creates the illusion as if it's a ghost of a carpet. And I would like to add that as a maker, I myself am a maker of things, of objects. I have great appreciation to the fact that this carpet was made for me, and I'm aware of the time that was put in it and the laborious work. And I think personally I interpret the idea that someone makes something for someone as an expression of love. That's it. Thank you very much, CultureBuzz, and I hope you come to see my exhibition. It is open until sometime in October, so if you're in Tel Aviv.